How to write a children's story. Writing a children's story requires a vivid imagination, good speech, enthusiastic creativity and the ability to put yourself in the mind of a child. To write a children's story, follow these helpful guidelines. Writing your own children's story. Brainstorm story ideas. The story is perhaps the most important aspect of any good book. Consult some of your favorite books, children's or otherwise, for inspiration, but do what is ringed for you. Choose a story that fits your interests and talents, such as action, fantasy, or mystery. If you have children, involve them in the brainstorming session. Say something like, but if you want to make your brother, sister go to bed and she didn't want to. What would you say? Or, what would a dog do to avoid eating his vegetables? But their minds will come up with me send you into fits of laughter, or even a whole new direction in level of creativity. Part of the great fun of a children's story is that it doesn't need to be realistic. With fabulous exceptions like The Lord of the Rings, etc. This is the biggest difference between children's and adult books. Of course you can write about a talking mongoose. Sure you can write about a human with a dog's head and three legs. Children will appreciate such absurdities. Develop your characters. To have a good story, you need some interesting characters. Who is the main character of the story? Is there more than one? Are the characters human, animal or fantasy, or do they include elements of oltre? Before you begin, make an outline of the characters and how they fit into the story. You can also take a cue from Ilunga R.R. Tolkien or Ilunga K. Rowling, and create an entire world that your characters inhabit. Even if a lot of that does not appear in your story. It will inform your characters and help the actions make sense overall, even if it's nonsense, as long as it fits in the framework of the world you have created. Make sure your writing is age appropriate. For example, smaller children enjoy stories with simple, or non-existent, plots and plays on words, for example, a repeated phrase like, no, no fat cat. Scat. 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 On the other hand, older children will want a more intricate plot and a tone that treats them like they are not children. Since it's harder to put yourself in the mind of a very young child, consider some of these guidelines and example story themes for very young readers. Ages 3-5 years, use sentences with a low level of complexity that explain the motivation behind actions shown on the page. Themes include, adventures, getting lost and finding your way home, going to bed, fighting, being brave, sharing, telling the truth, thinking of others before yourself, explaining how you feel, learning to spell, learning to add. Telling parents if someone hurts you or makes you feel bad, how to resolve arguments, disappointment, or dealing with the loss of a parent, brother, or sister. Ages 5-7 years, use bigger words but be careful to explain them so as not to frustrate new readers. At this point, books can be long enough to read over 2 or 3 innings. Themes that you can use might include overcoming challenges, learning new skills, understanding good reasons to do something and bad reasons to do something, magic, or confusion. You can also tickle their nascent rebellious streak, with stories about running away from home and joining the circus, flying an airplane, or snacking a popsicle. Make a story outline if necessary. Unless you're writing for a very young age level where it's appropriate not to have a traditional plot, ex. Go on with mon, it's wise to carefully plan the story structure in advance. Use note cards, draw it in picture form, or write a standard outline. The important thing is to have a general understanding of the beginning, middle and end of the story, and of all the characters will interact and evolve. A good story usually has some sort of conflict or obstacle that the main character has to resolve, after which the hero lives happily ever after. Here's the breakdown. Introduce your characters with descriptions of physical and personality traits, their surroundings, and those that won't they come in contact. Create a problem or conflict. This could be between two people, an internal conflict, or one in which the main character overcomes an obstacle in the outside world. Write the climax of the story, which will include the main character's coming face to face with the conflict. Show of your character's resolves the problem and what happens next. Make sure your writing has flair. Use humor when possible. For your own children, focus on the silly things that will have about the killed and the adult reader logging together, use made-up words and simple rhyming schemes. Dr. Seuss knew that this made it much easier and more fun to read aloud, for children and parents. Fox in socks, Anione. Whenever possible, show the character's personality through speech and actions, not bland statements like Sally is selfish. Sat instead, Sally took the bucket from Tommy. It's meaning of, she said. Try to differentiate between different characters by having them react differently to the same situation. Draw your inspiration by watching children in action. Consider whether or not to add pictures. If you are a professional illustrator, adding your own artwork can add to the interest level of the story and make it easier to follow. However, if you are not a professional, publishers most likely won't be interested in your design ideas and will replace them with images created by another illustrator that are famous for the happy and love emotions they produce.